It's all right. There we go. Good evening. Good to have y'all here with us, Centerville Baptist Church. We come here to preach, and I understand. Is that all right? Now, I'm going to have George with us tonight. They're going to be singing and leading us in worship tonight. And we're going to have a word of prayer. And I'm sure you've got a prayer need, a prayer request, and the Lord knows. If you've got a prayer need, a prayer request unspoken, raise your hand. And we'll pray for that individual, that thing, that salvation, what it may be tonight. Amen. But let's have a word of prayer as we begin. We thank you for the privilege to come to your house again this Sunday evening. We thank you for allowing us to gather in your name. Thank you that you can take care of all our problems, all our struggles, all our needs. Thank you that you can take care of our requests that's on our minds. And you say, give us your petitions, made at your feet. God, we come to you tonight, and we just have all distractions put aside in a time of worship tonight. We do pray that you be with this group, Georgia. Thank you for coming with us. And just pray that you'll be honored and glorified everything that's said and done this day. In Jesus' name. Amen. I know a lot of you had your own church home, but if you're here for the first time and you're looking for a church and you want more information about Centerville, you fill out a visitor's card in the pew in front of you. And we'll have our regular offering in the beginning. You can drop that visitor's card in the offering plate. And then we'll have a love offering before Georgia later on in the evening in the service, okay? So at this time, let's stand together and let's sing Victory in Jesus, all right?
Sweet day out. thank you for bringing us back once again to just gather together to worship and glorify your name. Be with all the prayer requests that were spoken and not spoken, God. You know our needs, you know our hearts, and all things you're sovereign. Just be with the rest of the service as we worship you. Just may your spirit fall down on us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's stand and greet one another.
See, you look up here that you see Jesus through this group right here. All we came for is to see a soul saved, to see people encouraged. Ain't that what it's all about? I want David to come sing a song right now that talks about that very thing. Brand new song over our brand new CD that's entitled, Ain't That What It's All About?
To a brighter day.
Excuse me tonight. Yes. Now I am about fact, all of us are Baptists except for this one over here, and he's a Methodist. Did you go under the water?
He's the just one. Pray? He's the one with all the shout too. Yeah. We trained him.
I'm an excited Baptist, though. You just have to excuse me. I get excited when I think about that glory road where I'm going to go one day where there's no more sickness. There's no more wheelchairs. There's no more cancer. There's no more death. There's no more crying. Baby, I just get excited. You have to excuse me, and if you don't like it, then guess what? I don't really care. I'm teasing. Thank you so much for having us. Georgia, so excited to be with you here tonight. What about this tenor singer? Did you enjoy my friend, Mr. Terry Bell? And real quick, anybody here in Georgia for the first time? Three or four? Oh, yeah. Wow. Yeah. Okay, well, let me just tell you, Rodney's back there raising his hand. Let me just tell you, this brother right here has had the group Georgia since 1975. He started singing when he was 5 years old. He's been singing for 60 years. Wow. And I think that's quite an accomplishment. I love him today. I'd make welcome Mr. Terry Dale from Gilson, Georgia.
So I came in here tonight, and thank you so much for each of you dear friends, and thank you, good pastor, for the opportunity to come tonight and sing. Two guys in the back that take care of all of the engineering part of it, and also take care of the equipment part, and we really appreciate them. Yes, I wish you never feel welcome tonight. That's my son. He's a sound engineer. That's my other adopted son that does all the equipment. That's Rodney and Danny in the back. Would you mind? And over the past 2.5 years, we have traveled and sang many, many days. And people love this next young fellow. What an addition he has been to the group, Georgia. And we,
he said young.
Okay. I should have qualified, but he's the one with the curly hair. And so, step on up, buddy. But this one right here has been a real pleasure to work with for the past 2.5 years. And God has blessed our ministry. We have been so blessed. I didn't come here tonight to brag about anything, except to tell you that in the past 22 months, Georgia has been blessed, and we're working on the fifth one. But we've had four top 40 songs in the nation. And what that means is that it's on XM Satellite when it goes on the top 40 songs in the nation. And our music has been heard around the world.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Sings a wonderful lead, and he's going to sing some songs for you tonight that'll bless your heart. Would you make him welcome from Maysville, Georgia, Mr. David Preston? Woo! Some of you who have seen us for years know that this is a very familiar face to Georgia. He and I have had the privilege to work together for the past 19 years, and what a blessing that has been. I really appreciate him so much. You know, I'll never forget how I really met him, and it was through he's a driver, and he's a fast driver, and so I met him one day. He's in the clutches of an officer's hand. I pulled over. He was a young fella, and I pulled over to find out what that was, I really felt sorry for him. He's just a kid back then, just a new driver. But he drives fast. He does. And so he had got stopped on 985 coming out of Gainesville there. And I pulled over. I knew the officer, and I said, I was going to beg for, to not do much with this young fellow. And he walked up beside his car, and he said, can I see your license? I went right with the officer. And he said, Mr. Smallwood, he said, I've been waiting on you all day. I'll never forget what Reggie said. He said, I just want you to know I got here as fast as I could. If you put him on 85, he runs 85. Get out of his way if he gets on 141. Okay? Would you make him welcome from Gainesville, Georgia, Mr. Reggie Smallwood? I want to sing a song right now that's been so good to us. If you look at the Singing News magazine next month, you'll find that this song is number 33 song in the nation. And I want you to listen to this because of the message that it contains. People love it. You see, in life, I've been way down in the bottom, Pastor. Yeah. I've been to all, I mean, but through my experience and through knowing the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Savior, you know, when I go slip all the way to the bottom and it feels like there can't be any more, I found that at the bottom there's a blessed holy rock in the Lord Jesus Christ. Listen to a brand new song that says, "Bend to the Bottom."
Promise to prepare.
why don't you do a brand new one that kind of slows down just a little bit, and say whatever you want to about it, and let's do this song. Here's a brand new song.
First of all, I want to just ask you, do you have an album? Because if I had you playing at my house, I would just stay so relaxed, just listening to you play. Just very, very wonderful, wonderful job.
Most of the time I see you relaxed anyways. Anytime you get a nap, you do. That probably put you out, tell
me. That's about enough out of you, I'm going to tell you. Folks, we've just put out a new album, and I'm not going to say a whole lot about it. I'm going to let Terry David talk about that in just a little while. But there's a couple of songs on this album that, when we were picking these songs, I listened to these, and we listened to them collectively. And these songs just really ministered to us. You know, when I stand up here, we're gone Sunday after Sunday, Saturday night. We don't get to hear about preaching. So when we're singing these songs, a lot of times they minister to us as well. And these songs right here are very worshipful. I know I'm not going to point anybody out. I know there's people here who have been way down in the valley. I know I personally have a story. I'm not going to go into a deep story. But I will tell you there was a time when I was addicted to prescription medication. I was as low as you could get. But you know the Lord never turned loose from me? See, He never moved. I was the one that got away from Him. Sometimes it takes an event like that. I know when everything's good, me personally, when everything's good, we tend to kind of say, okay, Lord, thank you for this day, amen. Then when things get bad, we call upon Him. But you know what? He's there in all circumstances. And He wants to hear from His children. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes it takes a valley to bring us back closer to God. And you know what? Through all of that, when He picked me up out of that valley I was in, got my life straightened back out, He's been so good to me. David's going to follow this song up with a song that simply says, God's been good. Best song I've ever heard him do. He sings it with his heart. You know, God's been so good to me. We were talking on the bus. I promised Terry I wasn't going to say a whole lot, and I'm not. I'm going to stop. But we were talking on the bus. The simple fact that you could get up out of bed this morning and have another day is a blessing. Folks, I don't know everybody's heart here tonight. I know there's bound to be some people here that's hurting. Maybe you have an addiction. Maybe you've lost a loved one. I don't know. Maybe it's financial. I don't know. But you come to this altar right here, and you can get it all straightened out. Because God is so good. Listen to these two songs and worship with us. Thank you.
When I've cried the Maybe it wasn't my night. But let me tell you, God has been so good to me. And I think we can all agree that through all the stuff of life, isn't it amazing that God sticketh closer than a brother? Amen? I've got 4 little grandkids from 7 years down to 6 weeks. And my daughter, we raised her to know the Lord. She sings in church. She sung with me for many years. And she's raising those babies to know the Lord. So each time we sit down at a meal, I'll put the meal out and I'll say, all right, who wants to pray? And old Caden, he's 7 years old, he'll raise his hand. Pap, I want to pray. He'll begin to pray and just thank God for his family. You know, pray like a Baptist preacher when I walk in the door, you know. Then the middle one, I'll take, is anybody else? She'll say, I want to, Pap. And used to, she did, she'd say, thank you, Father, for this food, or, you know, and sing her little song. So the other night I said, okay, Cameron, it's your turn. And that child began to pray. And for the next 15 minutes, she thanked God for everything around and about her. Her mama just had a baby 6 weeks ago. She said, and help mama with her tiredness at night. Just everything. And I thought, the utterance of a child touches God's heart, amen? He tells us to be his uncle as a little child. We came this way tonight. That boy prayed a prayer with us a while ago. And just weeped and cried and asked God for his blessings upon the ministry and upon you tonight. He said, we don't know, you know, we never know who's going to be here. But he asked God to come in tonight. I'm so glad he prayed such a humble prayer, because I'm going to be honest with you. I feel the presence of a holy God tonight. Amen. We've had a lot of success in the last few years with this group, with songs and all that kind of thing. But let me tell you this. Brother Terry, he preaches to us all the time. The most success you can have is to witness the Spirit of God upon what you're doing. Tonight has been awesome thus far. I don't know your heart tonight. I don't know what I know. I've got a brother right back here. It sort of breaks my heart because his little companion sat with him every time that he come to hear us. And he told me a while ago, he said, Brother David, pray for me. He said, I had to put her in the nurse. She's in the nursing home now for 3 months. I want y'all to pray for my brother back here. We've got ones right here that's lost a loved one. And I don't know what's going on in your life. I'll tell you, most everything's going pretty good in mine right now. I've got a brand new little grandbaby and all this stuff. But we never know what tomorrow holds. Amen. This could be our last service. What if? My wife said to me last night, she said, darling, I tell you I love you every time we are hanging up on the phone. I said, yes, you do. I really appreciate that. She said, here's why I do that. I don't know that we'll ever have that conversation again. She said, something could happen to you, something could happen to me. If Georgia don't ever get back this way again, I want you to know that our heart loves the churches. We love the people of God. What if the Lord comes tomorrow? And we just all meet up there in that class. Amen. Amen. God bless you tonight. I just wanted to give my word of testimony. I don't know what the next song is, if it's a barn burner or not. I don't know. But I just wanted to give my testimony. I love you tonight. Some of you come week after week after week. I don't see how you endure our songs week after week after week. But thank you for your support. Thank you for your prayers. This thing gets, we leave our families every weekend. Sometimes they get to come, sometimes they don't. And it's a ministry, okay? We're on the road weekend after weekend. Not to get famous, no, but to bring honor and glory to Him. Just a few weeks ago, we were singing outside. Got done with our song. And this little 12-year-old boy walked up and wanted to give his heart and life to the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen? That's what it's all about. We sing all of it. Sing a song. God bless you.
I think what I want to do right here is just, you know, it's been good tonight. Thank you so much. And I've always tried my best to stress the part that I don't care if we're singing in front of thousands of people and if we're in a big arena. It's always the story never changes. It's not about us tonight. It hasn't been in any way. But let's make it all about Jesus.
Amen.
What a wonderful time it's been together. And you know, there's something that's sticking with me. I remember this young fellow's wife that came. Every time they would come around, she would always want to hear you sing one of the old favorites. And you know what? I want you to sing that old favorite tonight. And listen, the invitation has already been given. If you're here tonight, you don't know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you can find Him right here tonight. If you don't have the shout that you need, right. if you need a closer walk with the Lord Jesus Christ, then you can find that tonight. You can find it right where you are. You can find it right here in this altar by coming. So I want to tell you something. It all started for me when I was 9 years old, many years ago, and this gospel song here stayed number one in the nation for so long. But I'm going to tell you tonight, I'm so glad that there's a lighthouse that shone many years ago.
Yes.
And it, thank goodness. Yes. You know, men, and I've said all along, you know, that it would go out. It may have flickered a few times, but let me report to you tonight, it shines in my life brighter than it ever has. And I'm glad that it continues to shine. Sing it good tonight. The lighthouse. Sing it good tonight.
There's a lighthouse on a hillside that overlooks life's seas. And when I toss the bout, you know it sends out a light. A light that I might see. And the light that shines in darkness would sail no more. Oh, everybody that lives around us, all around us, they say, why don't you tear that lighthouse down? They say, we all know the big ships, they don't sail by this way anymore, and they're just ain't no use in that old standing round, but then my mind goes way on back to that stormy night when just in time I saw the light. It was the light from that old lighthouse that still stands up there.
Georgia without some kind of real strong upbeat type thing. And we've been talking about this all night. It's all about Jesus and everything else. And we have a song that was top 40 for us that says simply, it asks the question, most important question you'll ever ask yourself or anybody else. I wonder tonight, do you really know him? Now this is one of them right here. Anybody that's reserved or anything like that? There have been too many in the house tonight that's reserved. But at the same time, if you're a little bit reserved, this is one of them where you can get loose too. Yeah, the ones that haven't clapped your hands yet. You've been nodding your head when we get on the flashlight. Yeah. So this is one of them where you can just get wild, okay?
Yeah.
Hey, you ain't got to worry about us. You won't scare us. No. What's it matter anyway? We're going back to Georgia. Yeah. Just to get to let's do a song that says, do you know him?
Six CDs together, older Georgia CDs. I put them in a pack, and I'm letting you have that tonight for a $15 donation. Six CDs for $15.
Yeah.
It comes out of your check. What we're doing on this weekend is anything off of that rack back there is considered newer product. That's all been recorded in the last 2.5 years. most all of that on the rack is $15 each. So what we're doing, or what I'm doing, is if you'll take something off the rack, which is $15, and take that CD pack, which is $15, I'm going to let you have all of that for $25. That's 7 CDs. Brother Terry's really going to get me here. On top of that, I'm going to throw in a DVD. If you'll do the $25 pack tonight, I'm going to do a DVD free for that. So that's actually 8 pieces of product for $25. Now let me say this, we do not have our brand new CD with us. It's actually in production, and we'll probably have it 3, maybe 4 weeks, something like that, in our hands. If you would like to pre-order that, sometimes it takes them out, or one of those new songs, you just gotta have that. We'll just take your address tonight. You pay for that, we'll let that consider be the new piece of product, and I'll let you take home, well, here's what we'll do, for $20 you can have that, and I'll give you the DVD for free, okay? $20 if you just want that back, or not free, but anyway, if you'll do, come by and see me, I'll make you a deal, how about that? I'll treat you so many ways, you're bound to like one of them. All right, and what I'll do, with any purchase, when you get one of our promo picks, I've got a couple of those back there, gardening season's over, but you might still want. And let me tell you a few more things. We have a website. It's GeorgiaGospelTrio.com. The name of the ministry is Georgia. I tell this everywhere we go, but I couldn't get Georgia.com. You can imagine that. So it's GeorgiaGospelTrio.com. Same thing as our Facebook, all capital letters, Georgia Gospel Trio. We'd love for you to come by and comment on tonight's service or whatever that you would like to do. On Sunday mornings, I understand that one of our radio station that we're on Sunday morning is actually reachable here. They're 100,000 watts. It's 99.3 on your FM dial on Sunday morning at 7 o'clock while you're getting ready to go to church. We have a one-hour gospel program, okay? Just us and a lot of our friends. You can hear our schedule and all that kind of thing. If you'd like to tune that in, if you can't get it on the FM dial, all of our devices nowadays live stream. You can go to WCON.com and you can live stream that for free, okay? So again, tune that in if you get a chance. Last thing I'll tell you about, we have a singing at sea. Now, how many's ever been on a cruise? All right, yeah. It's a lot of fun. Mary didn't have a real fun time on hers, but most everybody has a good time on their cruises. We have one. A lot of the groups get together, you know, and have their multiple singings and that kind of thing. The Lord has gave us our own travel agent, and along with her work and Brother Terry's hard work, we're able to just have a Georgia singing at sea, okay? Just us. We take a preacher with us. What we do is each night on that ship, we're going 6 days and 5 nights. We have our own stage, so we do a performance each night. On Sunday, we turn that stage area into a church, and we have meeting. We take a local Baptist preacher with us. He preaches for us. We sing, just have a good old time in the Lord. If you're looking for some kind of Christian getaway, Christian vacation, this thing's going to be the last of February in 2018. Bleeding into the first week of March, that week right there, we'll be gone. We have a bus travel that we talked to you about and all that good kind of thing. So if you're interested, we would love to take you with us, and we'll have a good time in the Lord, okay? Again, thank you so much for allowing Georgia to come by tonight. We love you, and we thank you. We turn it back over to the pastor.
David.
Yes, sir.
We came up here tonight, so it's not that far down I-85.
Okay, yes, I forgot that. We have singings, you know, every week, you know, but we've got one I want to tell you about in particular. Anybody know Karen Peck in New River? Okay, down in Maysville, Georgia, in my hometown, we're going to be at the Grove Level Baptist Church, and we're going to have Karen Peck in New River with us, and we're going to have a local group there from Jefferson called the Pruitt Family. They singing that Jesus built this church on love. You remember that song? They're singing that right now. Got it on the charts. If you come out tonight, we have tickets, $12 here, $15 at the door. And we'd love to have you come and be a part of that service. It's going to be the third weekend of November. We have flyers on it tonight. Come by and get a flyer, and we'll talk to you about that. Again, thank you so much for allowing Georgia to come by tonight.
Y'all enjoy that night? Yeah. And before you leave, do you know him? If you don't know him, get to know him. I'm here available to pray with you. One of these guys from Georgia. church neighbor, just grab her hand. Lay the Bible down and lay the salvation. So if you don't know it, know it before you leave. Amen. All the fun to you tonight. We thank you again for the blessing you've given us tonight together. We thank you for this ministry, Georgia. Thank you for them coming and singing, lifting their voices up to you. Thank you for blessing our hearts. We pray to you to use their ministry throughout the area they go. And may you touch many lives. God, we thank you for your salvation. We thank you for dying on the cross and rising again for us. And giving us life and heaven and hope in the future. Be with us as we go. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The words will be on the screen. This is our benediction song. You got it? It's in the back. Well, we're just going to go. She can't play. All right. We're just glad to have you here. And the number downstairs, if you need to go down this hall, there's steps down this way, or you go around the building and around if you'd like to have some cake, okay? Thank you for being here.